Hi, this is Keith Pierce, and today we're going to look at a demonstration of Autodesk Buzzsaw. Now, Autodesk Buzzsaw is cloud-based collaboration for the entire extended project team, providing secure access anywhere, and includes features we'll look at such as BIM viewing, mobile access, and easy administration. So let's get started. And I'm going to log in. Now, I could be on a Mac or PC. I could be in Firefox or IE. So you have multi-browser, multi-platform support for Autodesk Buzzsaw. And right now I am in NT Works Limited, my project site name, and here you see my project structure. So these are my individual projects. I could navigate here, or I could use thumbnails. You can see we have images here of the folders. I'm going to go ahead and go into Folsom Point. Now I'm at the root level of the Folsom Point project, and down at the bottom you can notice thumbnails. So we've got thumbnails in Buzzsaw, and these are created when you load the items into Buzzsaw. So you've got some DWF files, you've got a PDF file, you've got some DWFX files. But let's say we want to take a look at a model. An important part of Autodesk Buzzsaw is being able to go in and have BIM viewing. So looking at Revit and Navisworks models. So I'm going to go into the Architectural Design folder and go to 3D Revit model. Now again, you see thumbnails of the Revit models. Very important for navigating. I'm going to click on the Revit model, and it's going to bring up thumbnails of all the views that were generated in that Revit model. And all these thumbnails were created when that Revit model was loaded into Autodesk Buzzsaw. So the only thing the designer had to do was get that Revit file into Buzzsaw, and the cloud would do the rest. I'm going to select second floor 3D. This brings up what we call a preview. So this is just a quick check. Yes, is this the item that we want to take a look at? It is. So I'm going to click on Interactive View. Interactive View allows me the ability to go in and pan, zoom, and rotate that model, as well as look at properties that I may need to view that were associated with that model. For instance, I'm clicking, let me zoom in a little bit. I'm clicking on this wall, and I click on Properties, and it pops up Basic Wall. So I can go to close out. So I can investigate the model. And again, this is just one of the views that was generated in the Revit model. I could go back out to the document details and look at all the different views that were created. Now, on the Actions button on the top right-hand side, we've got several options. And this is permission-based, of course. So I could download that Revit model. I could move it to another location within Buzzsaw, rename or lock. And then I've got notifications. So notifications are important in Buzzsaw because oftentimes in a project, especially with a large extended project team, you're exchanging lots of information. Designs, new designs are going into the system, new project documents. Here we're looking at a Revit model, but again, keep in mind Buzzsaw can manage any file type. So it could be a Word document, a PDF. Buzzsaw doesn't care. And I want to get notified when something changes. So I'm going to click on the Edit Notification button to show you an idea of what you can get for notification settings. I can be notified immediately, or I can be notified daily as a summary. So if I'm tracking lots of different things within my project, I can set that up so I get a summary email every day that says these are the new versions of the items that have been loaded into the Buzzsaw cloud. In this case, I've got immediately. I'm going to go ahead and save that and leave that where it is. Another important item is this versions button. So versions, I click on this, and it's going to show the different versions that are available in Buzzsaw. It will show multiple versions if they had been put up into the system. You also note upload new version. So here's where I could upload a new version, choose to go and browse that version, upload in the system. And we'll talk about loading in a little bit. So that's basic functionality for Buzzsaw. I went to the Folsom Point project. I navigated visually via the thumbnail of the project and then into the folder for the Revit models. I looked at the views through thumbnails, and then I chose which ones I wanted to take action on or pull up a view of and have a look at it. Now the same thing could be done for DWFX files. Here we're going right into that file, and again I can pan, zoom, rotate, and I'm going to choose a door in this case and click on Properties. So here's information on that double glass door. And again, same thing on the Actions button. I could download this, I could choose to set a notification, I could upload a new version or check and see what versions exist. Let's go back to the document list. So one other thing I want to point out. So we just looked at RVT files, Revit files. You could do the same thing with Navisworks files, and we pulled up a DWFX file that we could view. Now let's talk about DWGs, because people have asked me about running DWGs and in the browser, what can you do with DWGs? Well, as you see, we can pull up the viewer and take a look at that. So we can go in and view that file. Now, if we wanted to edit that, a benefit with Autodesk Buzzsaw and the web is that you can go in and there's an action button, view or edit online. If you click view or edit online, this is going to go in and launch a session of AutoCAD WS, enabling you to go in and view or edit that document. So that's an integration between Buzzsaw and AutoCAD WS. Now going back to the document list, I mentioned earlier we talk about upload. So I can go in, there's several ways I could get information. I could be in that document looking at that and click the upload button. I could be here and click the upload button or create a new folder. But what if we're in a design application, we don't want to open Buzzsaw, we don't want to click upload, search for it. Well, that's where something called Buzzsaw Sync comes into play. Now keep in mind you're going to see Buzzsaw Sync today, but there's also Project Sync for Vault Collaboration AEC, which provides a direct integration from Vault to Buzzsaw, allowing you, for instance, to take a Revit model that was stored in the Vault or Navisworks files that may be involved in workflow and send those directly into Buzzsaw. That's Project Sync. Buzzsaw Sync is a desktop application that allows you to go in and synchronize from your desktop to Buzzsaw directly without having to get into the Buzzsaw application. Here we have my sync folder. You can see it's got a big B on it and a checkbox. This is syncing to my construction documents that are in the Folsom Point project. So I'm going to go ahead in the background and go over and show you the construction documents here. So let's go ahead and take a look at these here and move back to my Buzzsaw folder. So imagine that you're a designer, you're working in Revit, Navisworks, or you have some other file you need to upload into Buzzsaw, but you don't want to have to open up the application, you don't want to have to interrupt your workflow, you want to do a simple save or you want to just drag and drop. That's where Buzzsaw Sync comes into play. I have this folder set up to sync continually. In other words, as soon as I drag and drop a new file or a new version of a file into the sync folder, it will synchronize to Buzzsaw. You can set this up so it does it manually on your command, or you can set it up so it's timed every day. So let's say every day at 6 o'clock, when everyone's out of the office, I want to take everything that is in this folder and sync it to the Buzzsaw site, I can easily do so. So for a quick example of how this works, I'm just going to grab a PDF file, a data sheet, and I'm going to drag it into here. Say I want to move and replace, and then what you're going to see happen, there it goes, is you see the sync icon changes here. This shows that the file is currently syncing with Buzzsaw. And the syncing is complete, so if I go and take a look at the PDF document that I just uploaded, I click on that, you see it says last modified moments ago by Keith Pierce, and if I click on versions, it reflects that I just uploaded a new version only moments ago. So you can imagine the ease of use in regards to Buzzsaw Sync as far as Revit files or Navisworks files. You may not want to go into the Buzzsaw application, click the upload, browse to that. You can do your work in Revit, Navisworks, or any other application. You can save to the Buzzsaw Sync folder, and then it will take care of syncing that to Buzzsaw automatically. Also, because Notification Manager is working within Buzzsaw, if I had notifications set to the datasheet I just uploaded and that was put into Buzzsaw, I, as the user at the other end, have gotten an email that said, hey, here, take action on this document, a new version is there. This is very important when you're talking about a construction project across an extended project team where you have lots of documents going around. It's important to maintain the latest version and to know that you've got access to the latest version of a document. That's Buzzsaw Sync. So we've gone in, we took a look initially at the web user interface, we pulled up a Revit model and looked at a view there, we looked at a DWFX model, we just showed you how you could upload a document, any kind of document or design file with Buzzsaw Sync. Now what about mobile access? Now many of your users on the extended project team may need to access the project data on a mobile device. Well, the exciting news is that your users now have access to the same information on their mobile device. Buzzsaw is available on the iPhone and iPad, and on the iPhone and iPad it provides BIM viewing, so you can see your Revit and NWD files as we just demonstrated in the web user experience. You can view 2D and 3D DWF files, you can save those files like Office files for viewing offline, and you can upload project photos and videos directly from those applications. On the mobile app for Android, which we just released, you can view 2D and 3D DWF files. You can save office files for viewing offline, and then you can upload project photos and videos as well. So we're really taking Buzzsaw and providing that access anywhere, all the way to the field. There's a third way to access your Buzzsaw project data, and that's what I want to show you right now, what we would call the traditional Windows application. Here we have the Buzzsaw Windows application I'm sure many of you are familiar with. I'm going to log into the same site, the NT Works Limited project. As far as the UI goes, here on the left-hand side, we have some administration functionality as well as search. I can open up my project folder structure. I'm going to go into the Folsom Point project, and here you can see that list of folders. I can switch that around if I'd like to view it this way. You can see the different file types I have in here. One thing to mention about the Windows application is that you have the ability, we have number 10 civil details landscape here, you have the ability to go in with DWF files and perform markup. So if I needed to view this DWF file and I want to go in and do a quick markup of it, I could easily do so. Once I had that, I could go in, I could save that document, and then a notification could be sent to the project team. Now, adding files and folders, I could drag and drop individual files, or I could drag and drop entire folder structured with files into this interface to create that folder structure. Of course, we have version control. I won't save this markup. You can see the previous versions. And as an example of the drag and drop, I'm going to drag and drop a folder onto Folsom Point to bring up the wizard, and this is going to say you want to add this file, and if this was an AutoCAD file, a DWG, it would pull in the XREF, so I could pull in those AutoCAD XREF files automatically, and it would know to pull those in. I'm going to go ahead and hit next, just to show you what the wizard does. I could add a comment to a discussion thread if I wanted to, and I could email other people, and I could say, hey, you need to take action on this item, people on the project team, and let them know either by groups or individuals that there's a new version or comment on this file. Go ahead and cancel that. In this case, I'll just click finish. I want to update it so we know it is the new version. And if I go down to datasheet, I can see that this version was just uploaded. So drag and drop, notifications, version control, much the same as we saw. What can you do in the Windows application though? Well, you can go and you can administer your project. So site and project administration is very easy and straightforward in Autodesk Buzzsaw. If I wanted to create a new member of a project, I could go in and I could either pull them from the existing list of members to add them, clicking the Add button, or I could just click on the New. This would provide me the ability to enter a username, a first name, a last name, an email, and that's all that's really required, and then hit Create. Then I would create them and they would be added to the project. You can have project administrators as well as site administrators. Permissions are also very easily administered as well. Here you have a grid layout. We have the members of the project team as well as the folders. And I mentioned before that you have permission control down to the file level. We oftentimes joke in Buzzsaw that everything is simple as a right click, and within the Buzzsaw application it is. Here I'm just choosing some various folders, people, and permissions. If I want to change all those, right click, change permission. So that's Buzzsaw, providing cloud-based collaboration for the entire extended project team, from the desktop, to the web, to the mobile devices, anywhere, and includes key features that your team needs, such as BIM viewing and mobile access, as well as integration with other applications, such as Autodesk Vault Collaboration AEC. Thank you.